The Gold Coast is this morning in the grips of a COVID crisis, with more than half of the state's ICU patients now coming from that city.
Meanwhile, Gold Coast Mayor Tom Tate has called on the Queensland Government to simply let the virus spread through the state. The Gold Coast Mayor Tom Tate joins us live now. Good morning to you. I guess firstly, how are hospitals and frontline workers on the Gold Coast coping at the moment, especially if we are encouraging it, as you like, to spread?
Yeah, at the moment, the ICU units are working fine. We've got 11 cases there on the Gold Coast, and when you analyse that, you know, they're coping very well. But the interesting statistics is that 60% of the people in the ICU are unvaccinated. So the message is, you know, get vaccinated.
Mm. We're hearing from our reporter Mia Glover up there that there are COVID parties. Now, when I say COVID parties, that means people who are unvaccinated are coming together and just being brainless together, really, having these COVID parties. Your thoughts on that?
Oh, it's... I know one thing, the Gold Coast is a very innovative city, but this COVID party is really a no-go zone. They're all unvaccinated people, and if you're going to get COVID, that's the place to go and get it, because it's someone's going to have it, and it spreads so easily. It's a brainless idea, and I wish they wouldn't do it.
Well, of course, when you think about the strain that it could then have on the healthcare system as well, if people are being reckless at such parties. I mean, you're urging the state government to deal with COVID as we would with influenza. Are you not concerned, though, about the ICU numbers?
No, because you look at the cases behind it, there's other complication. As I said, the unvaccinated's going to cop it anyway. We said that. The other five people that's in there, they've got complications of other issues. So it's not purely because of Omicron. And I've asked the question, how dangerous is Omicron in comparison to a normal flu? I still haven't got the answer back to that, because I said in my letter, in 2019, we have 5 deaths a week for influenza, and on Omicron, we don't have any of that. So are we doing an overkill here? And if it means that it's not as, it's contagious, but if it's not as virulent, well, let it rip and let's get through the other side.
So what restrictions would you like to see scrapped?
Well, basically, the mask itself. I mean, when you look at people wanting to go to a restaurant, you know, you stand up, and if you've got a drink in your hand, you don't have to wear a mask. Or if you sit down, you don't have to wear a mask. You've got to explain the reason for that. Yeah. If I'm not asking people to disobey the law, I'm just saying that let's have a good close look at that. These testing that we're doing at the moment, really 9,000, 10,000 people getting tested. I mean, getting COVID. Is that the relevant data? The relevant data is actually how many people are actually in the ICU and the mortality rate. I think that's really the fair go.
Okay, Tom Tate, we thank you very much for your time this morning.
Thanks, Tom.
Okay, cheers. Bye.